Good morning again, everyone, and welcome to our morning worship and prayer. Let's prepare our hearts as we worship God together. Lord, we entrust ourselves to you, our lives, our families, Lord, the career, the vocation you've given us. And Lord, we would like to be able to offer all of these, Lord, at your feet today. May you be honored in our lives, in Jesus' name. Let's worship God together.
Curse and laugh, you do not fight. A thousand men yell, crucify. As crimson stains that fill your mind, you look upon me with delight. From throne to cross, you came to die. For thorns to bring new life. With every nail I fill your mind, you look upon me with delight. Oh, what love, how can it be? From that cross, you looked at me. Death gives way to glorious light and tears away the chains that bind. No sons and daughters in your eyes, you look upon. Poured out for me.
And Lord, we thank you for the life you've given us all over again. Thank you for the grace that you've extended to us and to each of our families in Jesus' name. Amen. Welcome again, everyone. And as we begin with our devotional this morning, I'd like to make this statement. As human beings, we all long to be judged. I know that's a bit odd, but that's not in a sense that you want to be negatively judged, but you want to know where you stand. For example, you know, my wife and I would often ask each other, you love me, right? It's not because we doubt each other's love, but we just want to be able to know and to be reaffirmed in terms of our love for each other. I want to know that my wife loves me. I want to know that my children loves me. I want to know where I stand in terms of my family. I want to know if what I do is something that's helping them or not. And that's the same way, even with work. I mean, you have your annual assessment or appraisals. You want to know where you're doing well at in terms of work or what needs to be grown, what needs to be improved, what are your growth areas. And we as a church, we also long to be judged. We want to know that we're pleasing Christ, that we're pleasing God in everything that we are. And that longing apparently is going to culminate in that day of judgment. Now, I know that already sounds like fearful to you, but you know, Paul would describe in 1 Corinthians chapter 3 a picture of what that day could look like. In 1 Corinthians chapter 3 verse 10, it says this: according to the grace of God given to me, like a skilled master builder, I laid a foundation, and someone else is building upon it. Let each one take care how he builds upon it, for no one can lay a foundation other than that which is laid, which is Jesus Christ. Now, if anyone builds on the foundation with gold, silver, precious stones, wood, hay, straw, each one's work will become manifest, for the day will disclose it, because it will be revealed by fire, and the fire will test what sort of work each one has done. Apparently, when that day of judgment comes, it will be a day of reckoning. It will be a day of clarity. It will show what our work has been. I mean, our lives, the way we've led our families, the way we've pursued our careers or vocations. And in the end, it will also, you know, Jesus will also judge us as the church. I'd like to begin to ask these questions. Lord, how do I know what will be the outcome? What's our assurance that the outcome will be good on our end? Lord, how can we know that we're really building right? I mean, according to you say that that day will reveal it to us by fire, how do we know that our work is something that will endure? It says in verse 10, Paul would say, according to the grace of God given to me, like a skilled master builder, I laid a foundation. And Paul was talking about the Corinthian church. I mean, he was the one who went to Corinth, preached the gospel there. People began to turn to God. It was a miracle. And eventually the church was established in that place. And Paul was saying, you know, I was a master builder according to the grace that God has given to me. And I laid a foundation. And then he says, and someone else is building upon it. We as every nation, as a global family of churches, and we as Victory here in the Philippines, in reality, all of the churches that have been built, the different denominations all across the centuries, have been built upon what our early church fathers have established. When they went to these different churches, established these churches everywhere, well, by the hands of Paul and by several other missionary teams and the rest of the other apostles of Jesus Christ, they went to these different cities, places, continents. And as these churches were established, we're simply building upon it. They laid a foundation, and we're simply building upon it. And then Paul says, let each one take care how he builds upon it. And apparently that's the challenge that's been given to us. Let each one take care. I'd like for us to just reflect on that a bit. How are we building? Now, of course, Paul was referring to the church. And that's also why we as every nation, our mission statement is that we as every nation, global family of churches, we exist to honor God by establishing Christ-centered, Spirit-empowered, socially responsible churches and campus ministries in every nation. This is how we're building. We're building upon the foundation we're building upon the foundation in the way that our early church fathers have built. And we as every nation, this is sort of our, in a sense, contribution to the church, to the global, to the universal church. And this is how we build. Now, if you notice from our every nation mission statement, there are three things that we do. We establish churches and campus ministries in every nation. That's church planting, campus ministry, and world missions. And the way that we build, or the way that we do it, is that these churches and campus ministries are Christ-centered, Spirit-empowered, and socially responsible. So as we continue to reinforce and talk about being Christ-centered today, apparently the foundation on which everything must be built upon is the foundation of Jesus Christ Himself. In verse 11, Paul would say, "For no one can lay a foundation other than that which is laid, which is Jesus Christ." Jesus Christ is that foundation. I'm really glad about that, because we don't need to invent anything. It's just we build on who Christ is and what Christ wants. That's who we are as a church. And when you come to think about it, that's also how you'd like to be able to build your life. You'd like to be able to build your life on Christ as the foundation, as the foundation of your life. You'd like to build your family in that way. You want your family to be built on Christ too. You want to build your vocation, your career in that way. You want to be built on Christ as well, because if we build on another foundation, then when that day comes and fire consumes our work, I don't know if anything will endure. So we have got to build on the foundation which is already laid, which is Jesus Christ Himself. Now, verse 12. "Now, if anyone builds on the foundation with gold, silver, precious stones." Now, I like those. Gold, silver, precious stones. Those look like quality materials. And then it says, "wood, hay, straw. Each one's work will become manifest, for the day will disclose it, because it will be revealed by fire." Now, I'm already thinking, Lord, how do we know if what we're building upon, the foundation of Jesus Christ, is gold, silver, and precious stones? How do we know if it's wood, hay, and straw? What determines if the work that I do with my life, the way I build my family, the way I build my vocation, the way that we lead, the way that we together build as a church, how do we know if our work is wood, hay, or straw? Is there any assurance at all? How do we know if it's gold, silver, or precious stones? And apparently the simple answer to that is when our work remains to be centered on Christ. When our work remains to be centered on Christ. We go back to that phrase that says, "Now if anyone builds on the foundation." The foundation is Jesus Christ. We build on the foundation. That word "on," that's a simple preposition, right? It's actually a general preposition, but it's often translated in Scripture. The most common translations would be "on" or "upon," or "and then in," and then "unto." So the idea of building on the foundation is that we build upon the foundation of Jesus Christ, we build in the foundation of Jesus Christ, and we build unto the foundation of Jesus Christ. That actually tells us that the way we build has to be upon Christ, in Christ, and unto Christ. Let's examine those three prepositions together. What does it mean to build on or upon Christ? I like to ask these questions. Is the way we build as a church consistent with Christ being the foundation of the church? Is it consistent with His righteousness, with His character, with Him being the Son of God, with Him being the Savior? I'd like to bring back the question to you. Is your life being built upon Christ? Is He now the Lord, the Savior of your life? Or are you still building on the basis of your own righteousness in relation to your relationship with God? Have you come to that point that you've recognized His work for you on the cross? That He died for your sins? And that He invites you to a relationship with Himself? Have you turned away from your sin and turned your life toward Christ? Have you surrendered your life to Him, being the Son of God and the Lord of your life? Is your life being built upon Christ? Then the next preposition is that it has to be built in Christ. For us as a church, are we building in Christ? Is the way we build being done by His ability and power, and not just by self-striving and effort? Is the way that we build in the church, is it done by Christ's grace, by Christ's ability, by Christ's power? Or is it just our simple fleshly contribution? Is it us trying to build the church by our own ability and strength? Is your life, is it filled with self-striving? Is it filled with a lot of self-effort that's not built? No wonder we're so tired and we're burnt out and, you know, it's not working. Is your career, you know, being built by striving, by your ability, just by sheer, you know, gifting and talent? Or is it being built by the grace and by the strength of Christ? Is the way you build your family being built by the grace? Do you trust God for your family? Do you pray for your wife and for your children? Do you pray for the affairs and the concerns and the situations in your home? Is that the way we're building? Is the dependence of the way we build on the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ or on our own ability and strength? And finally, as a matter of direction, are we building unto Christ? Unto Christ. You know, as a church, is the goal, the end goal, the ultimate reward, Christ Himself? Or is it growing larger as a congregation? Is it being known as a church victory? Is it having that many followers and having such a huge platform? Is it being recognized by institutions in our nation? Or is it really just about glorifying Christ? Is your life being built unto Christ? Are the goals and the dreams that you have now aligned with Christ's purpose for you? Is the way we build our families according to God's design for your marriage, that we are supposed to lay down our lives for each other, that we are to submit to each other, that the husband is to lead his wife love in a loving manner, that the wife is to be the helper in a submissive way and building upon the direction that Christ has for the home? Are we building in such a way that we're not exasperating our children, but instead training them up in the instruction, in the discipline of the Lord? Are our children being responsive to us in obedience and, you know, in respect? Are we building our home unto Christ? Are you building your career, your vocation unto Christ? Is that direction for your own advancement, for your own acclaim? Or is it to be able to glorify God and honor God in your career or in your vocation? Are we building unto Christ? To summarize that, you know, we are Christ-centered. We recognize that both as a church and individually, and also as a family. I pray that we would be Christ-centered. We would build our lives centered upon Christ. We are Christ-centered, and this now defines how we are with our lives, family, vocation, and church. We are Christ-centered, and this now defines how we are with our lives, family, vocation, and church. And I like how Paul challenges us back in verse 10, when he says, let each one take care how he builds upon it. Will you take care how you build upon it? Christ is the foundation. And so we build on the foundation of Jesus Christ. We build upon Christ. Is your personal life, family, vocation, being built upon Christ? Do we, as a church, build upon Christ? The way we build is not just upon Christ. It has to be in Christ. Is the way you build your personal life in Christ, by His strength, by His power, by His grace? Is the way you build your family, your vocation in Christ, by His strength, by His power? And do we, as a church, build in Christ, by His strength, by His grace, by His power? And finally, we not only build upon Christ as the foundation, in Christ as the foundation, but unto Christ as the foundation. On a personal level, do you build your life unto the direction and the purpose of the Lord Jesus Christ for you? Do you align your family toward God's design for your marriage and for building your home? Is your career and vocation designed to glorify Christ? And we as a church, is the way that the church is being built, glorifying to Christ? Is it pursuing Him? Is it increasing? Is it attaining or directed toward His glory? Is it about Him being glorified in everything that we do as a church? So we are Christ-centered. And this now defines how we are with our lives, family, vocation and church. You know, just the past weeks, we've celebrated the life of Bishop Ferdy. We've taken a pause, in fact, as a ministry and in our own personal lives to be able to honor his life. And I realized this, you know, I could still, the very first time I encountered him was when he was one of our pastors in Victory U-Belt. This was around 1991. And part of his challenge was always for us to give our lives completely to the Lordship of Jesus Christ. I love the way that he modeled that in his personal life, honoring Christ in every way. And then later on in life, I had a privilege of being neighbors with him for around 7 years in Pasig. And just being able to observe, see his family, see him as he leads his family, the way that he builds his family upon Christ. It's amazing. I truly honor this man. And then, you know, the way that he led in his vocation, that he, you know, from being a civil engineer to becoming a campus evangelist, that's how we called them in those days. They were campus evangelists, then eventually they became campus ministers, and now we call them campus missionaries. Bishop Ferdy was one of our very first campus evangelists. He would go on campus, he'd visit us, you know, at the lawn of UP Manila, our small group, and then challenge us to reach out our campus, you know, challenging us that even if we're just few in the campus, that we are a majority in Christ. And then finally, he was a huge man, one of our founding leaders as a movement here in Victory, in the Philippines, and even every nation globally. That he lived his life challenging us to go back to reaching the lost, toward evangelism, toward discipleship, toward raising leaders for Christ. This was a man who built his life upon Christ, in Christ, and unto Christ. May the Lord truly honor Bishop Ferdy, and we honor his family as well. We continue to pray with him. And again, thank you, everyone. Thank you, everyone, for surrendering your lives to Christ and building your lives upon Christ, in Christ, and unto Christ. Let's pray together. Lord, enable us to build on you, the Lord Jesus Christ, as our only foundation. Lord, thank you that it is by your grace. It is by your grace that we are built upon you. And today, we surrender ourselves to you all over again. Let's go ahead and surrender our lives to God in worship once again.
So glorious, came down unashamed. You called me yours, caught up in your grace. You're all I need. There's nothing more beautiful.
Lord, we're excited that as our lives are built upon you, in you, and unto you, Lord, you will cause our lives to be strong and stable in your foundation. I pray now that you'd be the one to build every single one of these individuals and families listening today, and that you would be the one to build your church in a strong and powerful and stable way. Would you now bless your people as we go? May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord cause his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. And may the Lord turn his face toward you and grant you peace. In Jesus' name, amen.